going through the grand believings of the word we connected. Now the sword for my song takes from me what I once borrowed, bigger stole from my tomorrow. Down the spiles and now I'll see. From the moment of my waking, life had always done the taking, and I'd always done the giving, living any way I can. But the treasures I had gathered, well, they never really mattered, and the only thing that mattered was what's done for fellow man. And the only thing that binds me to the ones I leave behind me are the many simple moments that show me that I care. And all the treasures that I leave them will be found within the memories of those precious little ones and the treasures we have shared. For the days that lay before as the story of my living gave unto the great meeting of the world we cannot keep. Now the soul is for my son.
Last year, so Andrew and I, along with Master Lewis, who's no longer here, formed a little music group called Bardic Storm. And soon to be Mistress Hala and Lady Kinwala and some others have come along. We did it for this Bardic Storm and friends. We played for His Grace in his camp last year. And everybody there said there was a group and they said that they truly despise bards. And we said, why is that? And they said, they never play anything we want to hear. And we said, well, what would you like to hear? And His Grace said, Stan Rogers. So we said, well, then we're going to play some Stan Rogers. And we had a great time, and His Grace was really incredible, as His Grace always is. So we thought that maybe we would just do a couple of Stan Rogers songs that some folks here might know or sing along to. These were ones he particularly liked. And we thought that would be a fitting way to pay some tribute to His Grace. So we're going to start with a little tune called Giant. It's about your ancient roots. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
Down, the glass down, jingle will rise. time.
My strap is out of control. I'm just going to change my tuning very briefly. And a particular sing-along tune. This was another requested tune. This is a tune some of you might know, so if you are happen to be familiar with them, it's called The Mary Ellen Carter. And it's another song, I think, that is pretty appropriate for this gathering. So if you know the refrain, feel free to sing along with us.
Seven.
more short song. This is a song that Dagan liked. It's an easy sing-along song, so you might know it's called Rolling Down to Old Maui. We thought that might be the appropriate song. So, it's in here.
Did you have the two extra ones?
No.
So,
if you don't know what the song, the refrain is, you'll know it after the first verse. So we hope that everybody who cares to would sing along with us. Master Phil has kindly offered to come and do this, to lead us through it, because he and I play this in another world.
Incessantly.
All right, it's all you.
It's a damn tough life full of toil and strife we whalemen undergo. And we don't give a damn when the gale is done, how hard the winds did blow. Cause we're homeward bound from the Arctic around with a good ship taut and free. And we won't give a damn when we drink our rum with the girls of old Maui. Rolling down to old Maui, me boys, rolling down to old Maui. We're homeward bound from the Arctic around, rolling down to old Maui.
Once more we sail with the northerly gale through the ice and wind and rain. Then coconut fronts and tropical lands we soon shall see again.
6 hellish months we've passed away on the cold Kamchatka Sea. But now we're bound from the Arctic around, rolling down to old Maui. Rolling down to old Maui, me boys, rolling down to old Maui. We're homeward bound from the Arctic around, rolling down to old Maui.
Once more we sail with the northerly gale towards our island home. Our mainmast sprung, our whale is gone, and we ain't got far to roam.
Our stunsail bones is carried away, what care we for that sound? A living gale is after us, thank God we're homeward bound. Rolling down to old Maui, me boys, rolling down to old Maui. We're homeward bound from the Arctic around, rolling down to old Maui.
How soft the breeze through the island trees, now the ice is far astern. Then native maids and tropical glades are awaiting our return.
Even now their big brown eyes look down, hoping some fine day to see. Our baggy sails running for the gales, rolling down to old Maui. Rolling down to old Maui, me boys, rolling down to old Maui. We're homeward bound from the Arctic around, rolling down to old Maui. Rolling down to old Maui, me boys, rolling down to old Maui. Homeward bound from the Arctic ground, rolling down to old Maui.
Thank you all. We do like that.
Yes, very much.
Thank you. here reopens the court of their majesties, Rombalder and Arabella. Their majesties invite into their court Lady Mica du Darregonne.
Pleasant to see you, my lady. Where's his grace?
This might say duty to inform you of your majesty that we have fought a battle for his cause bravely and valiantly, but the fates would not be denied. We will prevail, of course, until the summer.
We are sad indeed to hear of his passing. Great was his service to our kingdom.
We are both set. What may we do for you this day?
Every year at Pennsic, Your Majesty, His Grace would swear fealty to the reigning king. And we ask that you allow our household to swear fealty of his name to you.
We would be honored. This do we hear,
and shall never forget,
nor fail
to reward that which is given. Fealty with love, service with honor, and oath breaking with vengeance.
Why should I do so when there are so many in our service who could benefit from such a prize?
The lands are profitable and self-sustainable, Your Majesty. And we'd like to prove to you that we are capable of taking care of ourselves. You know, maybe show you what we have got.
Your Majesties, for your ailment and my dispenser, and we bring to you gifts of ceramics and in the clothing.
Thank you.
Houses support the crown. The crown supports the populace. On occasions when that you observe a member of the populace in need of support, by my hand I give thee 10 drachmas. Together, my lady and I give the crown 12 loaves of bread.
Thank you. Yes, you do.
Representatives of these allies.
Their Majesties invite into their court the representatives of the allies of House Red Winged Lion.
Will you defend the Duchy of Bowdoin to the best of your abilities?
Aye.
But wait, there's more.
Many more.
It's good to see that they're men.
It's like this. I don't want to break the game.
Wow.
Thank you.
representatives within this house?
Almost.
I am Duke Sir Eon Elegil, former Squire to Darregonne, the first Duke Dagan Squire to win the crown. I can attest from personal knowledge for the grant of the land to the duchy, and I will protect and defend that land with your majesty and Lady Lola.
Thank you. To the other representatives, will you also defend to the best of your abilities?
We will.
Aye. Thank you for your willingness to serve House Red Wing Lion. Take your leave. And we will consider your words.
For the allies of House Red Wing Lion, Hoobah!
Hoobah!
Lion, have any knights or masters at arms?
Call forth their order of the chivalry.
Their majesties call forward the order of the chivalry.
If there is a need to defend the Duchy of Odin and the House Red Wing Lion, will you do so?
Aye!
Knowing that Duke Dagan Squire's fealty is first to House Red Wing Lion, are there any among you who will mentor the squires of Duke Dagan?
Your Majesty, all these good men and women, if any are here, that are within the order that we have that served you, have been around these good squires of Dagan for a very long time. We know many of them well, and we look forward to helping them move along their path, whatever that may be. We hope maybe one day to stand among us, or just to be better men in the future. Where is right?
Thank you, good sirs, for this promise. You're dismissed.
Thank you, man.
Thank you. Thank you.
The order of chivalry. Hoobah!
Hoobah!
Your Majesties call forward those squires of Duke Dagan.
No, it's not.
I think there are nobody better keepers of these rings than yourselves.
Take these as tokens of years of service to Duke Dagan. For through him, you have served the crown in the kingdom.
Make a hole.
I have here a short list of squires also who are not present.
Kaywolf, Longstrider, Mikhail, Eisen, Oker, called Ironhawk, Arthur Pendragon, Albin Marshall, Sir Seamus McBain. Squires of Duke Dagan. Hoo-bah!
Hoo-bah!
This is a great gift indeed. We know of some who should... Oh, hold on. Sorry!
Call forth his grace's protégés.
As with his grace's squires, your fealty and service to his grace was service and fealty to us. Please take these tokens from our hand.
The Honorable Lady Saradwin Ariandellan. Paul Radun. The Honorable Lady Mir, Renolf Sinclair, Gregor Silberschmidt, the Honorable Lady Sophia Tides, Michael Calhoun.
Protégé service. Thank you.
For the protégés of Duke Dagan, Huba!
Apparently we are greedy majesties.
Midrealm access that his grace held in his service, and he used them when he was first on the throne. These are returned to you so that you may use them that your king is the one that will be the king.
Huzzah!
Huzzah!
This Red Winged Lion has protected the kings in the past. They have stood by the side of those of us who have served and eventually served as crowns. This is a right and fitting gift, and it will be a pleasure to be able to give these to the kingdom to remind people of that gift and the protection that was provided. Thank you.
Thank you for all you have done, Lady Mica. Honored His Grace. We grant you into your good hands the Duchy of Bowdoin. We look forward to many great times with the House Red Winged Lion under your leadership.
I am very proud to serve. Thank you.
Sorry, Her Majesty and I we are rarely in disagreement. And I will even more rarely refute what she says. You've proven to us the strength, the beauty, the vitality of this house and this duchy. So much so that I'm sorry, I must take back what Her Majesty has given. Only someone of nobility could lead a house like this.
As has been known in this realm from ancient times, it is the privilege of the crown to create certain honors and to bestow those honors upon worthy subjects at its pleasure. And foremost among these honors is that of court baroness. For to be created court baroness is to be admitted to the rank of nobility and to be warranted a special position in the order of precedence. And while a court baroness shall have no power, by that title over others, still shall that title bear suitable honor and great distinction for herself and her deeds. For a court baroness may be known by the title baroness, and then her proper name, and may wear, to signify her nobility, a silver coronet ornamented with 6 pearls.
You have stood as a noble lady, but been left unrecognized. This corrects that, and makes me pleased to put you in charge of this household and its lands. This part she didn't know.
Not on the screen.
Baroness.
For Her Excellency Mica, hoo-bah!
These gifts are spectacular. Some of them are perishable, so we would be pleased if they could be moved to a place where all here could enjoy them and remember why we are here and share our many stories over the many years of the gifts that he gave to us. Thank you.
There being no further business, here suspends the court of their majesties.
Thank you.